Hey YouTube, Brandon here, coming at you with another tutorial. What we're going to be talking about today is tweaking your system, specifically Windows 7, for gaming. This is going to be a bit of a long video, and I certainly apologize for that, but I'm going to go all-inclusive. I'm going to go from step one to step whatever, how many ever steps I got, and it's going to take a while, but I'm going to go through, you know, the services, I'm going to go through the registry, I'm going to do things specifically for SSDs. If you have an SSD, I'm going to teach you how to keep your SSD strong and happy. I'm going to go over RAID. I mean, I'm going to go over even how to shut down your computer faster. There is a lot of stuff in this video, and that's why it's so long, but I really like to make all of my videos fully inclusive. I don't like to leave anything out. If I do leave it out, it's probably on purpose because I don't want it to hurt your PC, or if it's something I think is shaky that the average computer user can't figure out how to do. But for the most part, I'm going to teach you how to get my your computer to boot in seconds, like my computer does. It's going to have faster speeds, the games are going to play smoother, you're not going to have weird random lag spikes when you're playing your games, you're going to have less fatal errors in your games, you're going to have less crashes in your games, the computer's going to be stable, and it's going to be awesome. So once again, I apologize for the length, but hey, we're diving into it, and sit back, relax, grab you a beer, and let's tweak the computer. A little bit of history about myself. I'm an old DOS guy. I'm not actually that old, but I grew up with a grandfather who was that Bill Gates type guy, knew coding back and forth, loved to write his own software, you know, and I grew up with him, and I was taught everything about computers when I was little, and taught how to take care of them and this and that, and because of that, I always run a really clean system. I like to have my system tweaked to the max. I like to get rid of all this unnecessary stuff that's running in the background. I like to have fast boot times. I like to have fast shutdown times, and I like to have nice smooth gameplay. This video, like I said, is going to be based on Windows 7. You can also use it for Windows 8, but your navigation is going to be a little different because Windows 8 is built on the backbone of Windows 7. So if you want to use this to tweak Windows 8, you can. Just know that your navigation and your menus are going to be a bit different, and you might have to do further research for that. Okay, so the first thing we're going to talk about is properly setting up your system from a hardware standpoint. I did already go over my specs, but I also have a Samsung's 840 SSD that I run for my Windows boot and one game, and then I have two 1 terabyte hard drives hooked up into a RAID 0. Basically what a RAID 0 is Windows reads it as one hard drive, and it's two hard drives, and what it does is it splits different pieces of files between the two hard drives, thus technically decreasing your read time in half, because it only has to pull half the file from each hard drive. Now it's a lot more complicated than that, but that's the basic premise behind RAID. Now RAID, there's different levels of RAID, but RAID 0 is the fastest in my opinion, but it does not offer any redundancy. So if you want to set up a RAID 0 with two hard drives, there's plenty of places to look on the internet how to do that. I highly suggest this for speed, but just know that you're not going to have any redundancy. If one of the hard drives fails, the whole system is going to go down. Okay, so, or the whole, all your data is going to be lost. So make sure you maintain these hard drives well and make sure they're in good working order and they're not too old to risk data loss. This is my SSD. Like I said, it only has 186 gigabytes of storage, but I only have the operating system on it and ARMA because ARMA has a lot of textures, and it's a program that's not optimized very well, and it only runs on one, maybe two CPU cores. Well, it runs mainly on one CPU core, and sometimes it disperses it a little bit, but not really, and so I help it out the best I can by giving it an SSD to load textures. Putting it on a RAID will also help it, but not as much as putting it on an SSD, and I try not to keep my SSD too loaded with other games. I put them over here, games that tend to run smoother on my system. I put them over here, as well as I put pictures and videos and stuff on this side too, and we'll also talk about in this video how to get the most performance out of your SSD as well, because there's certain things, if you have an SSD in your system, you might not realize you really don't want happening, or it'll greatly decrease the life of your SSD and slow it down. So I just want to go a little bit into the hardware side a little more to also help you, but just know that this tweak is based on having an SSD in a RAID. But if you don't have any of these, neither of these two, some things won't apply to you, and I will let you know which those are. Another thing I wanted to talk about this tweaking is I'm not going to do anything that could damage your system. I'm going to be very safe with it. If there is something that is a little iffy, or if you do turn it off, it'll stop other things that maybe I don't use, I will let you know beforehand. I'm not going to put something in this video that's going to ruin somebody's system. Just don't worry about it, okay? So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, guys, so we're going to go ahead and get started. The first thing we're going to start with is, so you just got your computer, and it's got a fresh Windows 7 on it. By the way, don't buy a computer from the store. Build your own. If you buy a computer from the store, it's going to come with all this crappy bloat software, and, you know, it's trial version, this and that, and that stuff is just garbage. You don't want any of that. So if you do buy your computer from the store, I would highly suggest the first thing you do is putting Windows 7 on it again without, just do a complete system reinstall, the first thing you do, and without any of that bloat software, just straight Windows 7, okay? So this is my system, this is my desktop. The first thing you're going to want to do is we're going to deactivate the user account control notifications. User account control is so annoying. It's that thing that pops up, are you sure you want to do this? And then, like, nobody ever stops. They just click yes, you know, so it's just it's not really doing anything but taking up processing cycles and RAM. So we're going to go ahead and click on Start Control Panel. And what I like to do is type right here, UAC. That didn't work for some reason. UAC. Change user account control settings. By the way, it's already implied in this video. I'll go ahead and say it now. You need to have administrative power on your computer or some of these tweaks won't work. Change user account control settings. And move it down. It's probably going to be up here. Move it down to never notify. Kill this thing forever. Okay, we don't want this. And then click OK. Also, you might see me click Cancel. Don't do what I do. I'm doing it because I've already done this. Just click OK instead of Cancel. Okay, so that takes care of user account control settings. Now, it's going to tell you that you need to restart your system for that to take effect. You don't have to do that right now. You can restart your system at the end of the computer, or at the end of the video, unless I say otherwise. Next thing we're going to do is change Windows Update settings. Windows Update, what it'll do is automatically check for updates from Windows, and it does it a lot. And believe it or not, Windows Update, automatic updater running in the background takes up a lot of processing power and RAM. So we're going to go ahead and turn it off. Windows Update, it'll tell you, oh, you don't do it, but, you know, whatever. So we're going to change settings, okay? And we're going to move important updates. Never check for updates. I know it says not recommended, but, you know, what I do is, here's your first warning. If you do this, your computer will not automatically download updates from Windows. Now, I don't see that as a big problem, because every once a week I do it myself. So just know that with this off, you are going to save some processing power and RAM, but you're not going to get the updates. So you need to keep it upon yourself to make sure you check for the updates yourself and download them accordingly. Okay? All right, next thing we're going to do is look up our startup menu. You're going to click on the start globe down here. You're going to type in msconfig. Hit enter. You're going to click on startup. Now, I can already see something on here that's snuck in here that I do not like. I do not like Larry Utilities to start on its own, and I do not like the Java Updater to start on its own. I guess it's been about a week since I've checked this, so... But basically, what you want to do is go in here and turn off things that you do not use, and you do not... Anything in this list is going to start up automatically down here when you start your computer, and you do not want that if you want a fast startup time and a clean PC that doesn't have a lot of stuff running in the background. So let's look at some stuff I turned off. I have a GoPro. I edit videos on this computer, and this is the Cineform status viewer. So basically, it down here, like, there's a GoPro attached, there's a GoPro not attached. Like, I don't need that, so I turn it off. Java platform updater, I turn it off because I don't want Java to update automatically. We'll talk about that in a second. Radeon Pro is turned off, because if I want Radeon Pro open, I'll open it myself. QuickTime is turned off. Now, be in mind, these are not services. These are just startup programs that start up when you start your computer. So you really can't hurt anything, with an exception, by turning it off. That's just stuff that you don't want running in the background when you start up your computer. Now, things to look out for. Do not turn off your antivirus software. If you turn off your antivirus software, it will not start and you will not be protected. Do not turn off your AMD or NVIDIA control center, because that will stop the graphics card from being controlled by the software. If you have an SSD, do not turn off the SSD software. And if you have Realtek Audio Manager, like I do, I like to have the separate audio manager as opposed to the Windows one. I do not turn that off as well either. These are four programs. They're very light, except for ABG, and they don't really slow down my speed very much. So that's startup. Just uncheck them. Click apply. Okay, it's going to say you have to restart. See the light. Watch this. Apply. Okay. You're going to have to restart for this to take effect. I'm just going to exit without restart because, like I said, we can restart at the end of the video. The next thing we're going to do is talk about the paging file in Windows. What is a paging file? Well, the paging file is basically your Windows detects that you run out of RAM, and so it moves that that RAM onto the hard drive and uses the hard drive as like temporary RAM. Which is a lot slower than actual RAM. And there's a lot of debate out there about paging files and whether you need them or not. Here's the deal. If you have 8 gigabytes of RAM or more, you really don't need a paging file unless you're running like super hard programs. Like, there is no game out there that's going to use more than 8 gigabytes of RAM right now. But if you do run Adobe Premiere or any kind of video editing software, look out, because those use a heck of a lot of RAM. So does Photoshop. So we're going to go ahead and look at our paging file right now. What you're going to need to do is click on the start orb, right click on computer, click on properties, click on advanced system settings. Under advanced, on performance, click settings, click on advanced, drag this over here. Now you're going to see virtual memory, aka paging file. Click change. Now, as you can see, I have 16 gigabytes of RAM on this computer, so I do not use a paging file. C is the default drive for the paging file. Right now it says none. Okay. If you want to turn off your paging file, click on C. Click on no paging file. Now this is the only place in Windows you have to do this. You have to click set and then OK. Okay, that's going to completely take the paging file off. And what that does is, a lot of people think that if Windows has a paging file, it will use it. Meaning, even if it doesn't need it, it'll default put some stuff in the paging file. Now, there's two problems with that. One, the paging file is not as fast as RAM. And two, see this C drive? What was that C drive? It's an SSD. SSDs have limited writing to them, meaning that it can only write so many times, and then it's going to die. So while your computer is on, if you have a paging file set to this SSD, it's killing your SSD, because while the computer's on, it's constantly writing stuff to the paging file, and we don't want that. If you have an SSD and you still want to use the paging file, just move it to your other drive. You can set up a paging file on your RAID or your another hard drive. Just, I really suggest not having it on the SSD. If you want to move it to the RAID, just click C, no paging file, set, and then click on D, and then do system manage size, set, or custom size, and set up your own size of a paging file. By moving this paging file from the SSD to another hard drive, if you still need it, you will save yourself a lot of lifetime on that SSD, because your computer is not constantly writing things to it. Okay? And if you want to turn off the paging file completely, just click C, no paging file, set, D, no paging file, set. If you don't have a D drive, that's okay. That means you only have one hard drive. But that's for if you have over 8 gigabytes of RAM, I would suggest that. So let's click cancel. Or you would have to click OK. I'm going to click cancel because I didn't change anything. And we're going to close out and get ready for our next thing. The next thing we're going to do is Windows performance. There's a lot of people who, when they start up the drive, like when I go to a client's house sometimes, I'll see like, you know, all these animations down here and this and that. Well, this guide is specifically for tweaking your computer for gaming. And when you're gaming, you don't need any of this fancy, you know, window pop up. Like, look how snappy my computer is. Look at that. You know, if I open games, boom, it's there. You know, there's no animations, there's no nothing. The arrow is off, and that saves you a lot of processing power and a lot of RAM. So let's go ahead and look how to do that. Click on the start orb. Right click on computer, properties, advanced system settings, advanced performance settings, and visual effects. So as you can see, I have a lot of stuff turned off. So I'm going to give you a second to look at this on the video so you can match. If you want, you can pause the video and match what I have. What you're going to want to do is set custom, turn all these things off, but keep on show thumbnails instead of icons, smooth edges on screen fonts, because you do want that anti-aliasing for your text or it's going to look goofy. Use drop shadows for icons, and use visual styles on windows and buttons. These things will make your computer look like this, but nothing fancy. You know, there's no arrow or anything like that, which saves you a lot of processing cycles. And I know it's not really necessary for a computer of my caliber, but I'm doing this video for everybody. And if you have an older PC, this will really help you. Really, really help you. So, that's that. Hey guys, Brandon here with another pop-in disclaimer. Something I found when I was going over the video. If you go here and you are changing those settings, those performance settings, like I said, so we're going to computer. That's not correct. We're going to right-click on computer and we're going to go to properties, exactly where you are in the original timeline of the video. And you click on advanced system settings and you click on advanced performance settings. So this is the window you guys were just watching in the video. If you mess with this stuff here, which is fine, which I told you to do, and then you go in here, which I just found out, and you click personalize. See, this is my theme. This is a custom theme, and it's a custom theme because I did that. Later on in the video, you'll actually see that I want you to switch to Windows 7 Basic Contrast Theme. If you do this, it's going to most likely mess with the settings that I just had you switch. I apologize for telling you to do that first and then this, but just be careful. If you click on this or change this at any time, it might actually mess with those settings. So when you do this in the video, which you'll see in a second, you might want to go back to this here, right-click computer properties, and then advanced system settings, performance, and visual effects, and make sure it didn't screw with this too much. Make sure it's still on custom and you still have these settings. Okay, back to the video. So I'm going to click cancel, you're going to click OK. We're going to close this and this. Okay. So the next thing, let me go over to my other monitor and adjust something real quick. Okay. Next thing we're going to talk about is Windows Defender. Turn it off and kill it forever. Windows Defender does nothing. If you have AVG or Norton, please don't use Norton, or anything else, you don't need Windows Defender. So we're going to click on Start, Control Panel, Windows Defender. This program is turned off. So I see that because I installed AVG, it must have automatically turned off Windows Defender, or I actually did it at the beginning. But for most people, this will not come up. Basically, what you'll do is you'll click on Windows Defender, and it's just like the Windows Update. You'll see settings on the side, and it'll say turn on or off this feature. You hit it, and then you turn off Windows Defender. You do not need Windows Defender. Notice how it's different from Windows Firewall, okay? Because it does nothing, okay? It really does. If you have a good antivirus program, you really don't need Windows Defender. It's just going to slow you down on boot and slow you down while you're playing games. Next thing I wanted to talk about was updates for software. Let me just show you for an example. I'm going to open up MSI Afterburner right now. And by the way, you see that my CPU is being used. That's because I'm recording lossless video right now, which is pretty crazy. We'll talk about this program in particular in a second, but if you just, like, this is what I'm talking about with setting. Check all your programs, Java, Flash, Adobe's horrible with it, Chrome, Google Uploader, Downloader, all that stuff. You can click Settings, General, check for available product versions, check for available product updates. Never, 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 never. What this is doing, you gotta go through all your programs on your computer that, you know, like, for example, Steam, Chrome, TeamSpeak, you know, OBS, you know, all these programs, they always have a feature in the settings like this to check for updates. You want to put that no, because if it's running in the background, or even if it's not, when the computer starts up, it will check. It will take up processing cycles and check for updates. Have you ever been playing a game and then all of a sudden there's this huge lag spike and then it goes away for a second? That's because some stupid program on your computer just checked for an update in the background. I absolutely hate this. I do not set any of my programs to update automatically. I do it myself. Once again, that's my theory on a clean system, nothing running in the background, nice fresh install, nice fresh boot up. And this is how you achieve this. It's going to take a little bit for you to go through all your programs, but trust me, you will see a huge performance increase and a big reduction in gaming errors and lag spikes by doing this to a lot of your programs. So that's my spiel on that. Next thing I want to talk about was background images. Like I said, I'm an old-time guy. I don't know if this is really true anymore, but I never have a background image on my desktop because it takes up RAM. The stupid slideshows. Turn off the slideshow in the background. I mean, that takes up a lot of RAM and processing power, too. It's really not necessary. Like I said, if you're just, you know, surfing the internet, use your computer for email, whatever, yeah. But this is a gaming tweak. Video, and for gaming, you really don't need a slideshow. It's just going to take up your processing power. Turn it off if you want. Right click, personalize, and this is the theme. See these arrow themes? No. You want to go to a high contrast Windows 7 basic theme, which is what I have now. Click on that, and then turn the background to a solid color and leave it there. That takes up a lot less processing power and RAM than any other thing. Okay, the next thing I'm going to talk about is write caching. You want to make sure that write caching isn't enabled on your SSD or your C drive or whatever you have, and you also want to turn off Windows write cache buffer flushing on the device because that will speed up your write and read times, thus giving you better performance in your gaming. So what we're going to do is we're going to right click on computer, we're going to go to properties, we're going to click on Device Manager, and we're going to expand disk drives, and we're going to right click on the drive we want and click Properties. There's such an easier way to do this, but I just realized. Okay, now we're going to click on Policies. Now, this, notice how I ticked, this is my Samsung SSD. Policies. You want to check enable write caching on this device. And as you can see, this improves your system performance by write caching. Basically, it writes it twice. It writes it into the cache real quick, and then the SSD takes over and writes it into permanent storage. So that way, it's not going straight to permanent storage. It might seem like there's an extra step, but it's actually faster this way. Now, turn off Windows write caching buffer flush on this device. Now, this speeds up your read and write cycles, but beware. Remember how I told you I wouldn't say anything that would damage your system, and I would warn you first? If you check this device, if you check this box, and your computer's right in the middle of writing something, let's say that you're downloading something to your SSD, and you lose power, you could potentially ruin, corrupt all the data on the hard drive. Because what Windows usually does is it writes the program into a little buffer flush, and then it writes it in. Now that's an extra step that we want to take off to improve our read-write cycles. That little flush is basically what saves the device in case of a power failure. If you're in a good area, then you're not worried about losing your power during a download, which I'm not, or if you have a battery backup on your computer, like I do, you can click this and not really worry about it, and that's going to save you some time on the read and write. So that is write caching in a nutshell. So you're going to want to check these two, and then hit OK. I'm going to hit Cancel. Okay, next thing we're going to do is talk about hibernation. Basically, this is a setting for laptops. basically, it'll go into hibernation when you're not using it. But for some reason, Windows 7 can't really detect the difference between a laptop and a desktop. So sometimes your desktop will actually have hibernation enabled, which tends to lag the CPU, or you know, you don't want to come back to your computer and shake the mouse and have it, you know, wake up. So as far as gaming performance goes, you never want your computer to go into hibernation. So we're going to go ahead and disable that now. In Windows 7, you're going to click on the orb, You're going to click on All Programs. You're going to click on Accessories. You're going to don't click on Command Prompt. Right-click Command Prompt and Run as Administrator. Very important. Okay, so we've got our Command Prompt here. Okay, and this is what we're going to type to turn off the hibernation. You're going to type POWERCFG dot exe space dash h space off. Hit enter, and that's it. It does it for you. It's not going to give you any kind of thing. It's a command prompt. But basically, that is a command that will disable hibernation for your computer. And if it's a desktop and it's always powered, you really don't have to worry about it. You don't need hibernation. It's just going to slow you down in the long run. So that's that. We're going to close out of the... Actually, don't close out of the command prompt. We're going to do the proper thing and click EXIT, Enter. Okay, everybody, let's go ahead and continue our quest for a nice, clean, fast, tweaked-out computer for gaming and other things. Now we're going to go into the services. Now, there's many different ways you can go into services. You can do it from the msconfig, but we're going to do it the super geeky computer guy way. And before I do this, remember I told you I wouldn't do anything that would harm your computer. This includes the services, but I do have to give you a disclaimer. Do not mess with anything in the services panel unless you know exactly what it is and what it's going to do and all these things. Because if you mess with something in the services panel that is important and gets turned off that shouldn't be turned off, you will ruin your whole computer and you will have to start all over again by installing Windows 7 again. It's a big pain in the ass, man. Just if you don't know exactly what it is, don't mess with it. It's just like the registry. It's very finicky, and this is like the core of your computer. So we're going to go ahead and mess with these. Click on the start orb. Let's go ahead and click on Control Panel and Administrative Tools. Once in Administrative Tools, we're going to click on Services. And it brings up this window. I'm going to make it full size so you can see it better. Now, these are things that are constantly running in the background for your computer, Windows or otherwise. Okay? And we're going to start by disabling a few things. The first thing we're going to disable is Remote Registry. Now, this is actually beyond tweak. This is a security issue in my mind. If you click on Remote Registry, where is it? Here it is. Remote Registry. Here it is. Right there. Remote Registry. If you read it, enables remote users to modify your registry settings. Why in the hell would I ever want somebody to disable or mess with my registry from the outside? I have no idea. So what you're going to do is you're going to right-click on it, and you're going to click Properties, and you're going to click the Startup Type Disabled, and hit Apply and OK. Okay, next thing we're going to do is Windows Media Player Network Sharing Service. For gaming, you do not need it, and it slows you down. So we're going to find Windows Media Player right here. I'll expand it so you can see it. Media Player Network Sharing Service. If you read it, it shares Windows Media Player libraries to other networked players and media devices. I have no idea what that does. I guess if you like use your computer to, I don't know, stream videos using Windows Media Player to your other devices, which there's better programs than Windows Media Player, I guess you would need to use this, but other than that, you don't need it. It slows you down. So you're going to right click it. Properties, disable, apply, OK. The next one we're going to do is Superfetch and Prefetch. Okay. A little bit about Superfetch and Prefetch. We're also going to have to go into the registry to fix these, but that'll be further in the video, so just relax on that. Basically, what Superfetch and Prefetch does is Windows likes to predict which files you're going to need and which files you're not going to need, and it likes to load them into RAM or get them ready to go, you know, and basically what it does is it slows down your startup time, and you really don't need it. I'm telling you, it just slows down your computer. It's more of a thing from Windows XP. You know, it's not really needed. If you have an SSD, if you have a RAID 0, if you have a decent computer, you really don't need Superfetch or Prefetch. It's just slowing you down. So, click on Superfetch, right click, Properties, Disabled, okay. apply OK. Next thing you want to look for is prefetch. Prefetch. Okay, prefetch is something we have to do in the registry. Apparently you can't turn that off here. Let me just double check, make sure I'm not missing it. Nope, can't turn that off here. So that's going to be something we do in the registries. Now, the next thing you want to do, if you are an NVIDIA or an AMD user, go up to AMD Fuel Service. You see this? Now, I have it disabled right now. I would be careful with this one. Some people say that it does some things. I've noticed absolutely nothing. It removes it from my startup, which actually gives me about, for some reason, gave me like half a second on my startup. So it provides fuel functionality. And when you look this up, AMD's so shady about this, they don't even know, like they won't, don't even put out any information about what it does. So if you're not going to tell me what the program does, I'm just going to disable it. If you don't want to, you don't have to, but this saved me on startup. I disable fuel service. Another thing is .NET framework. Let's look at that. I'm going to go here. Microsoft .NET framework right here. Now, be very careful with this because, see this? These two .NET frameworks are the version 4.0, and you need Microsoft .NET framework to play games. You need it, okay? It's very important that you do not disable it. But if you see here, I have it on manual. So let's go ahead and right-click properties. Now look at all these startup types. Automatic, manual, disabled. Now, I moved both of these from automatic startup to manual. What manual is, it's kind of misleading. It doesn't mean you have to manually start it. That means that this service will only start if a program requires it. Now, if you have it on automatic, that means it's going to start these .NET frameworks as soon as your computer loads. If you like nice, fast, clean computer boots like I do, it's unnecessary to have .NET framework moving all the time. So instead of disabling it, we move it to manual. That is, if I pull up ARMA, which requires .NET framework, ARMA will trigger the computer to start it manually. Okay, so it's not something you have to do, it's just if a program needs it, it'll start, as opposed to having it start all the time, which lags you on your boot and uses up a little bit of RAM. So I set those two to manual. These two were set to disabled automatically. I have no idea why, but I set these to manual. I think these are disabled because these, if you see, these are version 2s. So I think that's like a backup or something in case these fail, these come on. I don't know. I have no idea. Yeah, very important, do not disable these. Okay, there's some other things you can disable. Ooh, here's a big one. Indexing. Okay, we're going to go down, and we're going to talk about indexing in a second, but this is something you want to do right now. Windows search, right here, right-click, properties, disabled. Now what that does is it like constantly goes through your hard drive and indexes things for the searching in an attempt to speed up your Windows search. If you, like I said, if you have a good hard drive and you have an SSD, even on regular computers, you do not need this. It takes up hard drive space, and it takes up processing cycles, it takes up your startup time. It's basically useless. Now, a lot of people think if you disable this, you're not going to be able to use your Windows search. That's not true. Let's type in OBS. Okay, that didn't work. But I'll type in Dragon. Okay. I have it disabled. Obviously, I can still search my computer. If I type in msconfig, there's msconfig, okay? It's not going to actually disable the search function. What it does is it disables that search indexing, which slows down your computer. So we're going to go ahead and disable that. Like, properties, disabled, apply, okay. Okay, let's see. Ooh, print spooler. Hate print spooler. Where's that sucker at? Print spooler, right here. If you can read it, it's automatic red flag if you read it. Loads files to memory for later printing. So if you have like any file open that could possibly be printed, it's like Windows just moves it to memory for faster printing. Well, that takes up RAM. And I don't know about you, but I don't print from this computer. If you do print from your computer, do not turn this off. But I do not print from my computer. Somebody's blowing up my phone right now. How rude. Just kidding. I have print spooler disabled to free up some RAM. Yep. Okay. So that's about it in this. Those are your safe service tweaks. Like I said, if you don't know what it is, do not touch it in here because you will kill your computer. So we're going to go ahead and exit out of that. Okay, one more thing I wanted to add to the services, guys, is we went into the services menu and we turned off unnecessary Windows services. Another thing you want to look at is you want to click on the start orb here and you want to type in msconfig. Hit enter. That's going to bring up a little box here. You want to click services. Now look at all these services that are running. This is everything that's running on your background computer. Now all this looks like my eye glanced on parental controls. I think I'm going to turn that one off. But look at all these. Now you're like, man, how do I know which one to disable? Check this out. Hide all Microsoft services. When you click this, it's going to hide all the core Microsoft services that the system needs. Now these are services. Now this is different from the startup. These are things you've put on your computer, okay, or drivers or whatever. And these are things that are going to start and run in the background whenever your computer starts. And if you don't know what it is, do not turn it off in this menu because you may mess up some stuff. So let's look at some things I have turned on. Steam client service. This needs to be on because if it's not on, Steam won't load. Origin client service. If this is off, Origin won't load. Battleye service. This is something for ARMA online gaming. I keep it on because if it's not, I won't be able to get the multiplayer stuff. It only runs when ARMA's running. AVG watchdog. This is part of your AVG. Don't turn that off. AVG agent. This is part of your AVG. Don't turn that off. Now let's look at some things I have. Adobe Acrobat update service. So this is something on my computer that has, by default, was checked. And just like I said before, as soon as I turn on my computer, the service is going to start running and it's going to start pinging the Adobe server for updates over and over and over. Don't need that. I'll check for them myself. So anything that says update service that doesn't have anything to do with Microsoft or something critical you think, turn it off. Check this one out. Two Google update services. I think one's for Chrome and one's for something else. I don't know. But basically, turn them off. Because as soon as you start your computer, it's going to ping the Google server for updates over and over and over again. Radeon support. I don't need this Radeon Pro support. I think it has something to do with Radeon Pro. Even though it's running, even though it's not checked. Sometimes I use Radeon Pro to control some graphics in my games. But other than that, I'll turn it on myself if I want it. ACP user service and AMD external events utility. These are both AMD things. Look them up on the internet. They do have a purpose, but when I looked them up on the internet, I thought that purpose was weighing down my computer more than it was helping me. So, turn that off. If you want to. But basically, check this menu out, guys. And you want to hide all the Microsoft service, which is going to hide all the important system things, and go through these list of things you've put on your computer and make sure every one of them is absolutely necessary. If you don't know what it is, it's very easy just to Google this right here, like AVG watchdog service. Put that into Google and it'll pull up a million web pages just telling you, you know, if it's good, if it's bad, if it's a virus, if you should leave it on. So I would go through this whole list and make sure only things you absolutely need are checked. That'll speed up your boot time. It'll stop using processes for no reason, and it'll free up your RAM. So, good idea here, guys. And just make sure you click apply and OK. I'm going to click cancel, and it's going to tell you need to restart. Like I said, you can just restart at the end of the video. Next thing we're going to talk about is, the superfetch. We're going to go into the registry here. Okay, and we're also going to go into it later to Parker course, but that's on Parker course, but that's different. Remember the whole superfetch prefetch thing? There's one more thing we have to do in the registry to get that. So what we are going to do is we're going to turn off that superfetch and prefetch in the registry because that requires that as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on start, search programs and files, and we're going to click reg edit. Now here's another warning before I even click on this. This is even more important than services. Be very careful inside of your registry because one little 0 to a 1 or a 1 to a 0 or you click the wrong thing in this and the whole thing's going to die. I've seen it happen before. I'm not kidding. don't screw around with RegEdit. This is, by all intents and purposes, your computer right here. So we're going to make sure that we don't screw with that. So this is what you're going to see when you first open it. It might either just say computer or there'll be files down here. Computer, and here's all your roots. Now, to disable prefetch and superfetch, we're going to go to H key, local machine, hit the arrow. Next, we're going to go to system. Next thing we're going to go to is current control set. And the next thing we're going to go to is control. And the next thing we're going to go to after that is session. I'm sorry, session manager. And the next thing we're going to go to is memory management. And as you can see, we have prefetch parameters here. And we're going to click on prefetch parameters. Now, here's your actual keys over here. The first thing we're going to click on, we're looking for the enable prefetcher, and we're also looking for enable superfetch. We want to set the value of both of these to zero. So we're going to click on enable prefetcher, double click on it. You want this to say zero. If it says one or three or something, change it to zero, click OK. I'm going to click cancel because I already did it. Enable superfetch, double click, zero. Click. Change it to zero, click OK. Alright, so that's that. We don't have to save anything or anything. We don't have to click import, save, or anything. It does it automatically. And we're just going to click file, exit. So that's prefetch and superfetch disabled forever and ever. Okay guys, the next thing we're going to do is get rid of that unnecessary low disk space checks. And basically, drives are so large these days, you really don't need Windows constantly checking your disk to make sure they have enough space. Now it's just another tweak in the registry, so we're going to click on the orb. We're going to type in regedit and hit enter. And we're going to go, we're going to drill back up to our regular thing. Okay, and we're going to go to H key current user. And then we're going to drill down to software. And then we're going to scroll down and we're going to drill down again to Microsoft. And then we're going to drill down to Windows. Okay. And then we're going to go to current version. And then we're going to click on policies and highlight over Explorer. Now we're going to add a new D word. Edit new D word. And we're going to name it capital N O. Capital L-O-W, capital D-I-S-K, capital S-P-A-C-E, capital C-H-E-C-K-S. So as you can see, each letter of the word is capitalized. I don't know if that's even necessary, but that's what I do. Click off so it saves, and then we're going to give it a value of 1. So we're going to double-click, value data 1. And we're going to click OK, and then we're going to exit out of the registry. That was pretty simple. Guys, next thing we're going to do is some general registry edits to make the menus a little snappier and also change that mouse hover time to see that additional information faster. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to Start Orb, we're going to type in regedit and click on it, and it's going to bring you to this screen. And we're going to go ahead and drill down. What we're looking for is H key current user. And then we're looking for control panel. And then we're going to click on desktop. And actually, instead of bringing down desktop, I want you to actually click on the desktop folder. Now, over here, you will see menu show delay. You're going to click on it. This is a value in milliseconds. We're going to change that to 0. And then hit OK. That's going to make your menus snappier. Okay, so the next thing we're going to change is the mouse hover time. So like, you know how sometimes you hover over something and it will show you a tooltip. Sometimes it takes a little too long and I'm very impatient. Like I said, we're all about speed here. So we're going to, in the same drill down under control panel here, instead of clicking on desktop, I want you to click on mouse. Now, there is right here, it's called mouse hover time. double click. The default is 400 milliseconds. We're not going to change this one to 0. We're going to change it to 30 because I think it would be kind of annoying every time we went over something, it just popped up. So 30 is like faster than a blink of the eye. So even if you do stop for a second, it's going to pop up. But if you're going like this, it's probably not going to pop up. So we're going to change that value to 30. Okay, and that's how you edit those two things in the registry. Okay guys, the next thing we're going to do is disable disk defragmenting scheduler. There's nothing more annoying than playing a game and then all of a sudden, if you do defrag, and also if you have an SSD, Windows should have turned it off for you, but you also don't want to defrag an SSD or a dynamic drive. So we're going to make sure those are turned off because there's nothing more annoying than playing a game and then all of a sudden your drive decides, I'm going to defragment right now. So we're going to go to start. And we're going to right-click on... No, we're not. We're going to click on All Programs, Accessories, and System Tools, and Disk Defragmenter. Now, as you can see, it says Schedule Defragmation is turned off. I can turn on the schedule right here. C, never run. System Reserve, never run. RAID 0. It says the last time I did it was 12/19/2014. It was 0% fragmented, which... this should be never as well, but I think that was an accidental thing because at one point this was turned on. I forgot to turn it off. So you should see this. Scheduled defragmentation is turned off. That way your computer will never turn off or never defragment without you telling it to. And I think if it's on, the way to turn it off is somewhere on this page. I think it's either right here. It usually says turn on, turn off schedule or something like that. But you'll be able to figure out. It's pretty intuitive. You want to turn off this defragmentation schedule. And also make sure that the SSD is on never run. Also, sometimes when you click on the disk defragmenter for the first time, it'll say some other program is controlling your disk defragment. You must disable that. Do you want to disable it? Yes, because if some other program is controlling your disk defragmentation, then that's also not a good thing. So just go ahead and click yes. I don't want that program to control anymore. I want to control it here, and you want to turn it off. The next thing we're going to talk about is the Windows features. This is actually a part of Windows that I don't think a lot of people know about. I didn't know about it until actually about a year ago. It's kind of hidden in there, and basically it's pretty cool. You just go in, it's a GUI menu, you can turn off Windows features you don't use, which saves you in startup time and saves processing cycles and RAM. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on Start, Control Panel. We're gonna click on Programs and Features, right there, and then we're gonna click on Turn off Windows turn Windows features on or off. It's gonna load for a second. Always takes this menu forever to load for some reason. Okay, first thing we're gonna turn off is a remote differential compression. Right there, uncheck it. To be honest with you, I have no idea what remote differential compression... oh, computes and transfers differences between two objects over a network using minimal bandwidth. Wow. Okay. I was told by Computer Guru that I don't need this, and it slows down my computer, so I turned it off once, and I've never seen any difference whatsoever. So, I'm sure it sped up my computer. I mean, not by that. I mean, I've never seen... like, it's never crashed my computer. My network speeds are still as fast as they were. Yeah, I have no idea. So... print and document services. Since I do not print from this computer, if you do not print from this computer, you can turn all of these things off. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 programs that usually would load with Windows that you no longer need because you do not print or fax from this computer. If you do, leave them on. The next thing is media features. Okay, this one is weird. A lot of people say you can turn this stuff off. Look what happens when you do this. You uncheck. Oh no, Windows tells you if you turn off DVD, it might affect other Windows features and programs installed on your computer. So I clicked no. To be honest with you, if you're sure about this, turn them off. Like, if you never use Windows Media Player and nothing on your computer uses Windows Media Player and you're absolutely sure about it, you can turn it off and that will stop it from loading down here when you first turn on your computer. But I left it on just in case. But a lot of people say you can do that. Okay, tablet PC components. Most gamers do not use tablets for gaming, so you can turn that off. Windows gadget platform, which is so stupid. It has like the weather up here and like this and the news feed and all this stuff that slows down your computer. Windows gadget platform, turn it off. Windows search, leave it on, unless you don't want this, because you see this Windows search is different than the Windows search in the services. This Windows search, if you turn it off, it will disable the search down here, which I do not like. Hey, one more thing, guys. Sorry to keep cutting into the video here, but I keep thinking of things after I've made it, and I want to make this video as good as possible. So, talking about the whole Windows features thing, let's go ahead and navigate back there. I know you haven't left it in the actual video yet. Programs and features, and turn Windows features on and off. One thing I've got to tell you, you can tear an indexing service off right here, and games. I overlooked them because I had already turned them off. So games and indexing service, and I did some more research. You can turn off media features if you're not going to use those features. It's not going to mess with anything. But other than that, I don't see anything else that I missed. So back to the video. Okay, so you're going to click OK, I'm going to click Cancel. Okay, so that is Windows Features. Next thing we're going to talk about, and this is a big SSD thing, is moving files from your user defaults. So you know when you click on Start, and you click on Documents? Oh, it opens up all your documents. Now, the default is usually the risk for bleeding. That's a research paper I wrote. Sorry about that. If you click on Documents and open it up, its default position is in the C drive. So basically, let's say it's a Windows folder. Let's say that if I wrote something up, I'm typing, and I save it into Documents. Well, it's going to go onto the C drive. Well, like I said, all I want is my operating system on my C drive and ARMA. And the SSD has a limited amount of write cycles it can do, so you're killing the life of your SSD by having all these default folders going to your SSD. So what we're going to do is, it's very simple, you can do it for your Brandon folder, well, yours will say your name, Documents, Pictures, Music. All you have to do is right-click on the default folder, click Properties, and right here, see, it says that this is your Documents folder, but it's directed to a different folder on a different drive, CD. So if I actually click on Computer, RAID 0, you'll see it right here. This is the folder that those are actually, see, they're in here, they're on the D drive. So what you'll have to do is go into your D drive, make a new folder called Documents, make one called Pictures, make one called Music, and then simply point, it'll say something different here, like C something, just highlight it and click Remove, and then click Include Folder, and simply point it to that folder on your other drive. It'll pull up a browsing thing that looks just like this, and you just want to, do that. So that way all of these folders are pointed to your other drive, so it's not constantly writing stuff to your C drive and taking up your SSD memory and taking up your write cycles. Okay, another thing I wanted to add in was the temporary files on your computer. Now, a lot of people don't realize, but Windows saves a huge amount of temporary files all the time. And if you have an SSD, if you didn't know, the default location for temporary files is the C drive, which in this case is probably your SSD if you loaded it to, if you loaded your operating system to the C drive or to the SSD. Moving the temporary files to another hard drive allows you to save those read and write cycles on your SSD, therefore extending the lifetime because your computer's not constantly writing temporary files to the SSD. Okay, so in order for us to move the temporary file folder's location, what we're going to do is click on the Start Orb. We're going to right-click on Computer, click Properties, click on Advanced System Settings, click on Environmental Variables. Now you're going to see these two files here. These are the two temporary files that Windows uses. By default, they are set to the C drive. As you see, mine are not set to the C drive, they're in the D drive. Now it's going to get a little complicated because you actually have to point these files to a different file, but I'm going to make it easier for you because if you click in, you can't browse. You have to actually put in the variable value. So, variable value. So what we're going to do is, we're going to go to our Start Computer, and we're going to open up our other hard drive that's not our SSD, and we're going to create a new folder in here. Just name it temp files or something like that. As you see here, mine's called new temp files. I actually made it a hidden folder to kind of stop me from ever deleting it. It's kind of a silly thing. But whatever you make that folder, go ahead and right click on it and then click create shortcut. Now, as you can see, I've already done this in practice. I'm going to go ahead and delete this one. So down at the bottom, it should create whatever you named it, and then shortcut. I want you to right-click on shortcut and click properties. Now this is the, because I don't know your computer, I can't tell you exactly what to click. This is the path of your temporary file folder. This is what you're going to copy and paste into that, minus these little parentheses. I have no idea why those parentheses are there. So we're just going to highlight this without the parentheses, copy, cancel. Once you've copied that path, you can go ahead and delete this shortcut. Okay, go over here, and then that's the path you're going to put in both of these files. So you're going to click edit, and then paste what you copied right here in variable value and hit OK. And then we're going to go to the next one, edit, paste what you copied and put it right here, click OK. Now that will move all of Windows temporary files to the file you set up on your other hard drive. And like I said, what that does is it stops Windows from constantly writing temporary files to your SSD, which ruins your SSD's lifetime. Okay, the next thing we're going to talk about is your power settings in Windows. Now, if you have a desktop computer, which I'm guessing most of you do because you're gamers, Windows comes default, if you've never touched it, with the power saving feature turned on, which is great for the environment. It does all this and that. But what it does is it powers down your CPU, believe it or not. The processor itself is not receiving full power, as well as other things on your computer, because it's trying to save power. Well, you know, I'm gaming, it's plugged into the wall, you know, I'll take the hit on the power consumption, but I want my computer ready to go, full power all the time. So that's what we're going to fix right now. You're going to click Orb, Control Panel, Power Options. Some trouble finding these for some reason. Now, this says Samsung High Performance, yours will not say that. It'll say Balance. Now, it'll look like this. It'll say Balanced, Recommended, and then this probably won't be here. This is here for my SSD, but Show Additional Plans. You're going to click this, and you're going to click High Performance. You want this on High Performance. There is no OK button or anything, but you always, 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 for gamers, you want this on High Performance. And even after that, you're going to have to change some plan settings. So I'm going to go ahead and you're going to click High Performance, Change Plan Settings, but since this is the one I have selected, I'm going to go over here, and we're going to look at these plan settings. Turn Display Off. I have it on Never. I know it lowers the display time, but I turn the display off myself. Like, when I'm not using my computer, I don't run it. I shut it down. The monitor's only on when I'm using it. Pick computer to sleep? Never. But once again, it's just like the hibernation thing. Why would you want to put your computer to sleep? It's only on when you're using it. And plus, if you have this set and you're like doing a big download, and then you go, you know, oh, I'm going to download this and I'm going to go watch TV. Well, while you're watching TV, the computer could go to sleep and ruin your download or corrupt some data. So you or a big disk defrag or something. You don't want this. So we're going to click these on Never and then change Advanced Power Settings. Let me check my recording time here. I'm on 22 minutes. It's going to be a long video. Change Advanced Power Settings. We're going to put Require Password. No. Hard Disk. Turn Hard Disk off after Never. You don't want your hard disk to shut down. Sleep after Never. Allow wake timers. Here's the big one. Processor power management. Minimum processor state 100%. You never want that processor to go down. System cooling policy active. Maximum processor state 100%. This will keep power to your processor at maximum power at all times, giving you good performance. Display turn off after Never. So basically, we came in here for this processor power management. We want this on 100 and we want this one on 100. Okay, you're going to click Apply and OK. And then close this out. Okay, the next thing we're going to talk about is a pretty controversial one, but basically, I believe in it. Talking about is CPU core parking. Basically, what Windows does by default, I have an AMD FX8350, I've got 8 cores. And what Windows will do is, if that core is not being used, it'll turn it off. Basically, it'll park it. And so you're only running on 4 cores instead of 8, like these new energy efficient cars out there, these big trucks that have the EcoBoost engine, where it'll run on four cylinders on the highway, and then once you want to step on the gas or go through the mud, it goes up to eight cylinders. Well, everybody who has one of those cars knows that the problem is, if you're going down the highway on four cylinders and then you put that pedal to the ground, there's a pretty significant lag between the time that four-cylinder moves to the full eight-cylinder power. So for my computer, for gaming performance, or if you're editing videos or Photoshop, turn that shit off. So we're going to go to Control, Alt, Delete. I know it didn't show that on OBS, probably. But you're going to Control, Alt, Delete, start the task manager. Now, you're going to go to the Performance tab, and you're going to click on Resource Monitor. Then you're going to click on CPU. Now, or really don't have to, I guess. Now, you see this on the side here? This is how you're going to tell if your CPUs are parked. CPU total, server CPU usage. Now look, CPU 0, CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3. You can scroll all the way down. You see where it says 100% right here? If you scroll down on this list, in any of these CPUs, say parked next to them, CPU 7, it'll say like parked, 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 parked. That means core parking is enabled, and it is enabled by default on your computer, and you really don't want that because of the analogy I gave before. So in order to unpark these CPUs, we're going to have to go into the registry right now. Okay, so to go into the registry, like I said before, we're going to, hold on, I got to get the registry key. Okay, so I'm going to put this, there's a certain registry key you have to use to get to this, which I've put in the description of this video. That way you can get to it easier and you don't have to see how to type it. But basically, you're going to click Start, Reg Edit. Okay guys, sorry about that. I had to pause the video for a second because I actually ran into a problem with my registry. It wasn't finding the key, but I fixed it. So basically, what you want to do is you want to open Registry Editor, and you want to click Computer here, make sure that's highlighted, click Edit, Find. Now, in the video description, I want you to copy, I'm going to have this registry key right here. It begins in 0, ends in 3. I want you to copy this into your Find, have keys selected. Actually, go ahead and let's do all this, because I don't want to mess anything up. So we're going to, three times, these checks right here, and then we're going to click Find Next. Now this is going to take about 30 seconds on any computer because the registry is huge. So now I'm going to cut to when it finds it. Okay, so the registry finder found what I needed it to find. It took a little bit, don't worry, it's not frozen, it just takes a second. Now, don't click on anything over here on the left side. What you're looking for is value max and value min. What we're going to do is double click on value max. Make sure this says 0. It's going to say something like 64 or 32. This needs to be 0. Click OK. And value min needs to be 0. Click OK. Now, here's the tricky part. Pay attention. That only does it for one of your cores. You have to go through and do it. Say if you have an 8-core processor like me, you have to do it for all the cores. So, in order to do that, we're going to click Edit, Find Next. It's going to search the registry. It doesn't look like anything's changed, but it has. So once again, you're going to click on value max, 0, OK, value min, 0, OK. And you're going to keep doing this over and over and over again. As you see, I'm going to keep doing it. Notice I'm hitting cancel, not OK, but that's because I've already done it. Find next. Once again, it's going to finish searching through registry. You see that? I guess it was less than 8. So I mean, just it's gonna be as many as there are. So you're gonna have to keep doing that. Find edit. Find next. Changing all the value max and value mins to 0 until it says this. Finish searching registry. Click OK. When that happens, or it might not say finish searching registry. It might go to a different page. It'll just all of a sudden it'll load up something different on the side. It'll say like list something right here where value min is. Just keep doing it until it either says finish searching registry or these changes to a different page, and then you'll be done. You don't have to save anything. Just exit out of the registry editor. Okay, That is something you'll have to restart to take effect, but like I said, you could restart after the videos. Next thing we're going to do is make sure that trim is enabled for your SSD. Now what trim does is basically it's a Windows program. If you install an SSD, Windows should automatically turn on trim because it speeds up your read-write speeds on your SSD, but sometimes it doesn't, so it's better to just check. So in order to check and see if trim is enabled, we're going to click on the start globe, and we're going to click all programs, accessories, right click on command prompt, run as administrator. And as you see, you have this command prompt here. And what we're going to type in is fsutil, so F-S-U-T-I-L space behavior, B-E-H-A-V-I-O-R space query, Q-U-E-R-Y space disable. Okay, there's no spaces in this one. Disable, delete, notify, and hit enter. Now, it's going to pop up. You see right here it says disable, delete, notify equals zero. That means trim is enabled on my PC. Okay? So, if this says one or anything but zero, trim is not enabled. If you have an SSD, you need trim enabled. If you don't have an SSD, this will not apply to you. In order to enable trim, you want fsutil behavior disable, delete, notify, space, zero. This will set trim to on. I'm going to go ahead and hit it. Oh, I actually messed up. Hold on a second. Don't do that. fsutil, I'm sorry about that, behavior, set, disable, delete, don't want to do a typo either, delete, notify, space, zero. See what I meant? I didn't put set in there. You have to put fsutil behavior set disable delete notify zero. Okay, and then you'll see that disable delete notify equals zero, and that means we have successfully turned on trim. And we're going to click EXIT, get out of that, and we're going to move on to the next thing. Next thing we're going to talk about is indexing. Basically, what search indexing is, remember how we were in the services and we turned off Windows search? Well, there's also something else you need to do on your SSD so that that stuff is not indexed, which slows down your computer and actually takes up a considerable amount of hard drive space, because basically what Windows does is it sees a file and then it makes another tiny little file saying, hey, this file's right here. And believe it or not, it takes up a lot of hard drive space and slows down. Basically, it takes up a lot of hard drive space, and we don't want that, and it slows down the boot a little bit. So we're going to go ahead and disable indexing for you, besides on the... Okay, so click on the start orb, computer, see your SSD right here, right-click, properties. Now, we're on the properties. See this line right here? Allow files on this drive to have contents indexed in addition to file properties. You do not want that. It takes up hard drive space. It also slows you down. So uncheck this and then hit apply and OK. And it's actually, I think either as soon as you uncheck it, something's going to pop up because it needs to do, I think it calls like processing. It needs to reprocess the whole drive. And it actually takes about a good 15 minutes or 10 to 15 minutes for this to happen, and it's going to pop up and it's going to say Windows is processing, and it's going to have a little status bar, and it's going to free up a lot of hard drive when you uncheck this. So that's a good one. And then apply and OK. I'm going to hit cancel because I've already done it. So that's disabling indexing for the final time. One more thing I wanted to add, guys, when you go in to do this indexing, turn off the indexing computer, right click properties. When you turn this off, there's actually going to be a pop-up that comes up, and it's going to ask you, you want to click see as what you want to have the one highlighted that says see and subfiles and folders. That will do it to everything on the drive, as opposed to just, you want to have the one that says subfiles and folders selected. And then also when you push OK, it's going to give you an error. Just click OK and then click ignore all. and then that process will start. So I just wanted to add that in there. Next thing we're going to talk about is shutdown lag. Now, have you ever had your computer shut down? It's like waiting for this service to stop, to shut down your computer. Well, I really don't like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn off the wait to kill service timeout when shutting down. This is going to shut down your computer nice and fast and clean. So we're going to click on start orb. We're going to type in reg edit. As you can see, it's going to have what you had before up here. What you can do is, if you want to get back to the computer, like don't mess with any of this stuff. You don't want to mess up anything. So just hit your left arrow key on your computer, and it'll take you all the way back to the beginning. Now, this is called drilling down, by the way, what we're about to do. Drilling down in the registry. So first thing we're going to type in is HE key local machine. Next thing we're going to click on is system. And then after that we're going to click on concurrent control set. And then after that we're going to click on control. Now, after we click on control, you're going to find something that says wait to kill service timeout. And it's down here. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. We're not going to click on the arrow control. We're actually going to click on the folder itself for control. Sorry, I'm messing up all over the place. All right, you see this right here? Wait to kill service timeout. We're going to double-click it to open the edit string box. And the usual default value for this is 12,000, which is 12 seconds. So it's literally, when you click the shutdown button, your computer, on purpose, is going to wait 12 seconds to make sure everything shuts down and then shut it down. It's really not necessary. It just slows down your shutdown time. Change the value to 1,000. And click OK. And that's going to speed up your shutdown a lot. It's going to go ahead and it's going to disable that wait to kill service timeout. So we're going to hit 1,000. And you're going to hit OK. I hit cancel. And then, once again, it's another restart thing, but we're going to wait. OK. Next thing, there's a lot of debate out there about whether this actually works or not. But, you know, like I said, I'm going to show you everything I have on my computer. So we're going to click msconfig. We're going to click boot. And then you see how I have this checked? No GUI boot. You know how, like, there's that, it pops up with, like, Windows 7 and those little orbs fly around and it takes you to your password screen? Well, if with no GUI boot, it's just going to go straight to the password screen. So what you're going to do is you're going to click no GUI boot, and then you're going to click make all boot settings permanent. And then hit apply and OK. It's going to warn you. Are you sure you want to make them permanent? Yeah, it's fine. There's a lot of debate out there whether or not this actually speeds up your time. I think it does by about half a second. And I'm all about speed, so it's cool. I hate waiting for my computer to boot up. OK, the next thing I'm going to talk about is a few pieces of software I have on my computer that help me keep it clean and good to go. First thing is MSI Afterburner. This is not really a cleaning software, but it runs my graphics card for me. And AMD and NVIDIA graphics cards are actually notorious for their fan control. Like, it'll be like 90 degrees and the fan will be at 60% for whatever reason, who the hell knows. So I actually use MSI Afterburner to not only overclock my graphics card. Right now it's not overclocked, it's actually running at the profile, and the standard profile, and also I use it to control my fan speed. So this is a nifty little tool. There's lots of videos out there. I highly suggest using MSI Afterburner to control your GPU fan speed, and also to control the overclock, right? I'm not going to overclock it right now because I'm recording a video and I'm afraid it'll glitch it. So that is MSI Afterburner. And it also has a cool little hardware monitor. Like, I can detach it and it goes to my second monitor. And that way I can see it while I'm playing video games. I just downsized it. I don't know why I did that. Okay, so we're going to get rid of MSI Afterburner. The next program I like to use is called Malware Bytes Anti-Malware. I'm going to go into my utilities, and you'll see it's right here. Even though you have antivirus, this program is not one of those programs that's currently running in the background. It's a you just click on it and you run a scan like once or twice a week. It is amazing. It'll collect malware that other programs miss. And if you've never run this on your computer before, I guarantee you, even if you have antivirus, and the first time you run this on the computer, it's going to find all kinds of shit. And it's a great program. I highly suggest it. It is free. Just Google it. Malware and type. Malware bytes and malware. The next one is the SSD software. If you have a solid-state drive, you need to make sure that you go to your solid-state drive manufacturer site and get their drivers and get their software and make sure you run it, because this program allows me to optimize my SSD, which kind of cleans it up junk every once in a while. Make sure you have the good firmware. It's running the it's running the rapid mode. It's running the OS optimization and the over provisioning. We can talk about over provisioning in another video, but basically it sets aside a piece of the SSD. If you're a gamer, you really want to make sure your SSD is over provisioned, because it gives it a huge chunk of the SSD for the controller, which helps you get your textures loaded faster. Really, you want to have one of these programs, and if you do have it, you want to make sure that your SSD for gamers, see how the recommended is 10% over-provisioned. For gamers, you want that to be at least 20% for the controller. That'll make sure you get real fast texture load times. The next piece of software, I just want to talk about drivers and in general. You want to make sure that all your video card drivers, all of your hard drive drivers, all of your motherboard, your CPU drivers, you want to make sure that every single driver is the latest driver, because they're constantly tweaking their stuff to get the most out of your product. If you have outdated drivers, you need to go update them. If you need to know how to update your drivers, it's pretty simple. Let's say if you have a AMD graphics card, you literally just go to AMD's website and download the latest graphics drivers. It's really easy. We're going to talk about CC Cleaner next. Utilities, CC Cleaner. This is a cool little program. And basically what it does is it cleans all my temporary files off my computer for me without me having to do it myself. So it has a cleaner tab. You just run the cleaner and man, that thing gets rid of all kinds of junk. And it's great. The registry, if you scan for issues, it'll fix missing registry keys and all this stuff, man. This is a great program. Keeps your computer running fast. If you've never run this program on your computer, you really need to do it, because this program is so, it will speed up your computer. Like, if you've never run this program, the first time you run the cleaner, it's going to find like a gig and a half of stuff to remove. It's going to be so much faster after that. It's going to be great. The next program is AVG. I use AVG as my antivirus. The reason for that is because it's free and it's light. This is the recommended, if you do your research, AVG is the recommended antivirus for gamers because it's very light in the background. It doesn't pop up, it doesn't do crazy things. It just sits there and scans incoming stuff for viruses. It's very light on the CPU. Next thing is defragmentation. If you have an SSD, do not defrag your SSD. It will kill its lifespan, because like I said, it only has a certain amount of write cycles, and that is going to kill your SSD if you're constantly defragging it. And plus, SSDs are blazing fast, and it really does you no good to defrag it, so do not defrag it. If you have a regular rotating hard drive that is not set up dynamically, a drive that is a RAID. If you just have a regular hard drive, it's not set up in RAID or anything, it's really important for texture loading that you keep that drive defragmented. And I'm not just talking about defragmenting with the Windows utility. There's a program out there, I forget the name of it because I don't defrag anymore. It's called, I don't know what it's called, but it's like the best defrag program, and it's actually, you have to pay for it, but you can get like a 10-day free trial. And what it does is it allows you to defrag by what they call name, defrag by name. And what that does is, it's for gamers, it moves all of your files to the outer edge of the disk, and it also puts similar files together. So if you have, let's say, ARMA, it's going to put all the ARMA files on the outside of the disk really close to each other. So when you're playing ARMA, that disk head doesn't have to move very far, which means it's going to load those. It's not going to take a texture from this side of the disk and then another texture from the other side of the disk. It's going to make sure that all those files are physically close to each other so that hard drive can load them faster. And believe it or not, if you've never defragged your disk with one of these actual defrag programs that does it like that, you're going to see a huge performance increase with even a regular hard drive by doing that. I highly suggest it. The next one is Java and Flash. I just put that in there because Java and Flash are constantly coming out with updates. Like I said, you don't want them automatically updating, but you want to make sure you update those at least once a week, because those are security problems. And There's one last thing I have written here. It's called Black Viper. Basically, the Black Viper page, what it is it's a website. Just Google Black Viper, and basically he has a huge list of services there that you can turn off or turn on. I just wanted to, besides this video, I wanted to suggest going to his website. He has every single service in Microsoft explained, and he also has graphs on there of like, if you're a gamer, turn these services off. If you do this, turn these services off. He's got it all broken down, and he's all about tweaking his PC just like me, and he does a pretty good job. Okay, everybody, that's it for my video. I really hope you enjoyed tweaking your computer with me. After doing all these tweaks, your computer is going to be fresh. It's going to start up lightly. It's going to start up quick, and it's going to things aren't going to happen in the background while you're playing your games. And your computer is going to run so much better now. You're going to get such better performance out of these software tweaks that we've been doing today. And you know, I just really hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you have some good gaming. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter, as you can see down there at the bottom. And be looking out for all my other videos. Once again, I'm Brandon. Thank you, and have a great night.